but I still want that. So he's 45% now, dude.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Okay, welcome. Welcome, guys. Good evening. Please direct your attention to our students in the back. They will be coming in.
Please rise.
Please stand. Pretty. You guys all look handsome and pretty. If you please remain standing, direct your attention to the west side of the field to our American flag for the national anthem.
And run against red light.
You can be seated now. Maybe I should have pointed my lips that way, huh? Everybody would have probably went the right direction instead of being east, west, or north, south. Mr. Namoki, the MC tonight. So welcome. It gives me great pleasure to welcome all of our guests here today, from the parents and family members, our YouTube viewers, our school staff, our school governing board members, our honorable Hopi chairman and vice chairman, and finally our promoting class of 2021. At this time, I would like to take the opportunity to recognize our guest. We have Ms. Lynn Fredericks, our Hopi High School principal. Our board member, Sandra Dennis. Our honorable chairman, Mr. Clark Tanakongba. Mr. Albin Naha, our interim superintendent. And our Hopi chairman, Mr. Tim Nubangyama. Our board member, Justin Hongiba. Our other board member, Ms. Anita Benemtiwa. And Dr. Melbra Martin, our exceptional student service. Okay, today is one of our great occasions when we get to celebrate our young people. It was a challenging year, guys. But we made it, and you made it. You are now moving on to high school and are going to face new challenges. You have algebra, literature, welding classes, SAT, ACT scores. Asking yourself, where do you fit in high school? Learning how to juggle activities, extracurricular activities, your cultural responsibilities, and every parent's nightmare, boyfriend and girlfriends. These are the struggles and challenges that lay ahead. You know, I have a son, his name is Brady. You know, I'm waiting to brag for him when he brings home his first girlfriend. You know, I'm gonna go to the kiva and tell all the guys, you know, her Indian tacos this big. So these are some of the things that I know parents may not look forward to, but these are some of the things that you're gonna be challenged to as you go into high school. Okay. You know, normally I'm in my comfort zone in the classroom. You know, I love to teach. I love talking with the students. I didn't get the chance this year. You know, that's the big thing I missed, was getting to, you know, you guys. You know, we met last week in practice, and that was the first time I actually got the name with the face, and I'm glad that's happened. I'm glad that we have this tonight, what's going on, you know, your promotion. So when I found out I was to be the MC, you know, I was hesitant and scared. I was out of my comfort zone. Your freshman year in high school, some of you are going to feel that same way, hesitant and scared. Some of you are going to just fit right in. Some of you guys are just going to go right in there and jump right into that big giant pool and adjust fine. Okay, some of you will feel uncomfortable, like I said, and have unique challenges. For me, yeah, I was scared too, but I felt honored and I found the positive. I found the positive in this situation. I looked at it as a challenge, as a situation where I can gain experience and learn from the experience. I was asking Mr. Chairman here, while we're up here, I said, how would you? He said, just be yourself. So that's what I'm going to do tonight, just be myself. Okay, so you guys are all my students. And I may not be the best and make mistakes. However, I'm going to try and put in my best effort tonight. But I'm sure I will hear from my friends, Baker, Juwan, and, you know, John LaMavia. But at least I tried. So as you go into high school, I will leave you with this. No matter where life takes you or what path you choose, you always meet challenges. That is the way life is. So when you come to that fork in the road that makes you choose between this way or that way, remember that you are loved, especially with the people that are seated behind you and all around you. You are strong. Prayer will get you through those things. And you are wise. The greatest gifts lies within you. So thank you. Thank you for allowing me to be your MC tonight. Thank you. I'd like to introduce Mr. Alvin Naha for the presentation of the top 10.
That's the first time I've ever seen Mr. Namoki so nervous. You should see him. He's all shaking behind it. If you saw him, you might have never seen him shake like that before. So. But we're really proud of him and thank him for being our MC tonight. And wow, a promotion under the lights. When was the last time we've had that, right? So can you believe that? Look at that. Under the lights, on the football field. This is something new for us. And this is really cool. This is a very intimate setting tonight. And I just want to, before we get into the top 10, just want to thank our operations facilities department for putting pretty much all of this together. This is amazing. We got a brand new stage this year, so if you recognize, it's a little bit different than previous years. So we bought a new stage, and it's a lot bigger, a lot more room for us to stretch out because we also got a lot bigger in the last year, right? So I really gained those pounds. So this vest is just expanding more and more. So, but you know, just want to thank them also. Thank you, operations department. They're up there, security, parking. All of those individuals really helped out, so thank you guys. And most of all, our junior high staff, you know, they've been amazing. And they've been a consistent staff, and I'm really proud of them. They also helped all the decorating out here. We wanted to have a really kind of back to tradition, you know, our culture, and really that we haven't seen something like this in a while. You see that at the elementary schools, but we don't see it too much here in our promotions and graduations. So it's a beautiful stage. So thank you, junior high staff. And the awesome thing about them is they're all returning back next year. So all of our teachers are coming back for the junior high next year. And it's a pleasure to work with them. I just love them to death. We have a great time together. And we also look forward to many meals together. And we usually have breakfast together and those sort of things. And we miss that as well. So some things have changed, but we look forward to that happening next school year. So without further ado, I have the pleasure of announcing our top 10 promotees based on grade point average. So these are our top 10 students for the 8th grade class of 2020, and this is based on high academic achievement in all classes and based on their grade point average. So students, if you're one of the names who I call, when you come up here, please just start lining up behind me here. All right? We ready? This is in no particular order. We're really proud of these students, all these students, most of all, but these students really stepped up, had really solid GPAs, even during this year and a quarter of the pandemic, and they kept those grades up. They attended classes, and you guys all get to come up here. We'll give you a big whoop and holler, and you guys get to see the most beautiful sunset right now that's happening. So you get a nice view. So without further ado, our first top 10 recipient, Jeffrey Manygoats. They always look like racehorses with their big old things around their neck and everything. They look like they're like that. Jordan Lamakima. Jaden Yoyuki. Edith Silas. Norman Panana. Brianna Lamantewa. Man, don't they all look fabulous tonight? So handsome, pretty. Nanaba Novayakva. Keenan Honyaktiwa. Peyton Tachitni. And no, that's not their age over there. That's the year they're going to graduate high school. So I just turned that 2 years ago. So all right. Caitlin Haniestiwa. Ladies and gentlemen, our fabulous top 10 of the 8th grade class of 2. Oh, that wasn't me from this weekend. I promise that wasn't me. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, our top 10 of our 8th grade class of 2021. Give them a round of applause, please. And boys and girls, you'll be getting a little special gift. We got a little special bag for them at the end. So we put all their goodies in there. And so there's a little recognition in there for our top 10. And you guys can pick that up when you guys march out. So congratulations, top 10. And I'm going to go ahead and turn the time back over to our MC, Mr. Raleigh Namoki.
Thank you, Mr. Naha. Another applause for Mr. Naha. That number right there, you say turn that, that's about how much weight I gained over the quarantine period. I had to actually get a new one of these. The other ones were all, I could barely snug into them. So I ordered this one. Actually, I'll put a plug for him, Alan Paxson. He's a former student, so he made this. Well, that's about how much weight I've gained. Okay, next I'd like to introduce our Hopi Vice Chairman, Mr. Clark Tunakongva. He will be presenting the Salutatorian Award.
Good evening, or good afternoon, either one, I guess, depending on what time you're on. If you're on daylight savings time, it's probably about 9 o'clock already. For us people that work up from sun up to sundown, that's the real time, that's the Hopi time. But again, thank you. It's indeed a great honor to be here. You know, it's something else. It is with extreme humility and pleasure that I'm that I stand here before you today or tonight. I am truly honored for one to have been invited to this special momentous event of 2021. First of all, I commend all the parents, grandparents, guardians, families, administration, and especially your teachers that are here. We are here today, tonight. It is because of this help, support, and love that we share in their success of what we're celebrating today, their accomplishments, as well as those that will undoubtedly accomplish more in the future. As what has been stated before, it's been a very difficult year. Excuse me. Past 18 months, I don't know if you felt it the way I did, but it was on those days, nights, sometimes, that I had to dig down deeper than I've ever done in my life with this pandemic that hit us. Little did we know what was coming. What was told, I remember, back in 2019 of January in tribal council, that there was something that was coming. We knew it was in the Middle East. We knew it was coming to the East Coast. And when I remember the day, on the day in March, when tribal chairman Nivangyama called me to the side, and we sat in his office, and he told me that it was a possibility we had the first case here on Hopi. Little did I know how it would affect our people here. Little did I know that it would stop the complete culture, religious cycle of us as Hopi. That is what makes us very unique. Little did I know that the ceremonies were going to come to a complete stop. Little did I know that the chairman and I were to issue executive orders having to make you stay at home. Very difficult decisions. Very difficult decisions as far as the closure of schools. And look where you're sitting at today. In 2020, we were challenged with a pandemic, losing family, friends, loved ones across the nation and around the world. But as we emerge from this pandemic, as was said, we emerge stronger with renewed purpose and with a deeper understanding of what it is, it is important. I don't know how many of you recognize the word important. I felt it over the weekend. In over 15 months, I finally went home. I'm not from Palaka, I'm not from First Mesa, I'm actually from Hopeville. 15 months ago was the last real visit I had with my sister and my family. This past weekend was very different. It was sort of a unification, but yet at the same time, I am so used to wearing a face mask, sanitizing, not being around people in close proximity, and of course, partaking in one of our cultural rites in the ceremony. It took me back, way back. And I thought, I wonder if this ever happened to our people in the 20th and 19th centuries. I remember the smallpox epidemic that occurred here during the 1700s. That was the last big pandemic that I know that hit. And another one shortly after that, but it was nothing like what we experienced. When you lose over 100 of our community members, Hopi tribal members, it hurts. I am very glad to see you as the young people sitting here today. A lot of our elders made their journey. Who will now step up into their shoes? Who will take their place at the smoking circle, at the place in our ceremonies? These are some of the things that I recollect on, I think about, and it hurts. It hurts. But until you see it one of these days, boys and girls, young women, young men, you will know what I'm talking about here today. Hopi and other Native nations have always been resilient. We use that word loosely, resilient. And we owe this resilience to the strength of our communities, the wisdom of our traditions, and the fortitude of our families. These principles, what I spoke of earlier, have seen Hopi through many, many obstacles and challenges, what I spoke of. But to address the obstacles and challenges of the future, we will ultimately look to many of the bright minds and faces of today's promoting class. Therefore, as your current sitting vice chairman for the Hopi Tribal Council and the Hopi people, Hopi Tewa people, and other people that reside here on our great land, I commend and give each and of you many blessings, hope, vision, strength, and support to learn, grow, and carry yourselves and our people into the future, all the while remembering what it means to be Hopi, Navajo, or Native American, or of any other race. To be a part of this place, magnificent place, look behind you, how beautiful it is. To be a part of our Hopi society, and to be happy, healthy, and enjoy life to the fullest, as they say, at the blessing of your birth. May you live to be this old man, sleep in beauty to old age. I remember those blessings. With this, I say thank you, Kwakwai. At this moment, I am pleased to introduce Brianna Lomayintiwa, She comes to us from the village of Musanganavi. She is from the Bovolingam butterfly clan. Her parents are Dwight and Paige Lamayantiwa. Brianna attended one of our local schools here, Second Mesa Day School, home of the Bobcats. For her elementary school years, as a junior high student, Brianna participated in numerous extracurricular activities, such as AVID, Gifted and Talented Student Council, and ACES Prep. She showed her Bruin pride by participating in the sports of cross country and basketball. During her time with the junior high, Brianna was on honor roll student every quarter as a principal's list recipient. She also received recognition for her perfect attendance, which is great, outstanding, because as they used to tell me, you cannot miss a day of school or else you're gonna be behind a whole week. Brianna has a goal to obtain an athletic or academic scholarship to attend college at either Stanford University or Northern Arizona University. She aspires to one day be a mechanical engineer. Dream big. She hopes to obtain her college degrees, including a bachelor's, master's, and ultimately a doctoral degree. Thank you. Kwakwai. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the Hopi Jr. High School's salutatorian for the 2021 year, Miss Brianna Lomayantiwa. I know I was just going to come up and read her address here shortly, but before she does, I did a little gift for her and also the valedictorians. And I want to thank the group that I worked with for the last 4 years, which is Bears Ears, very important to me. And this backpack that I'm going to give you has got a few supplies for you to carry you into the high school. It was donated by the organization from Bears Ears. It's also got from my office, Office of Vice Chairman, Hope Tribe. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. Nut Brianna Lamayantiwa Yang Pahan Matiwa. Nut Honwis Nama Yang Hopi Matiwa. Nut Masang Nuxino. Nut Povolwongwa. Good evening, everyone. My name is Brianna Lamayantiwa. Thank you all for joining us here tonight to celebrate all of our achievements. First of all, I would like to congratulate the promoting class of 2021. I would also like to thank the faculty, staff, family and friends who have supported us during this difficult year. We could not have accomplished what we have today without the support, encouragement, and dependability of our parents, teachers, loved ones. To be honest, this school year was very challenging because of virtual learning. I see this year's virtual learning as a test of our character. We could have easily chosen not to log on to class and slept all day or played video games, but we learned to adapt to our learning environment, and we put in the hard work. Spent long hours after class getting our work finished and meeting deadlines. Also, if you had a bad Wi-Fi connection, we would have to look for ways to connect with our teachers, like logging in using our personal phones, emailing teachers, and calling friends to see what lesson you missed for the day slash hour. Another challenging thing about this year for myself was having younger siblings that were also virtual learning at home and having to help them when they were having difficulty with their schooling because my parents were at work. The most difficult part of the year would be losing loved ones to COVID. To all of you who have lost a loved one to COVID, I sympathize with you and I give my condolences. I too lost someone close to me, my kwa'a Patrick Sikakaka, who I love and miss every day. And I know he would have been proud of all of us. I feel that these obstacles and challenges are and will only make us stronger. This coming school year, I really hope to go back in person learning because I miss the social interactions with my classmates, teachers, and staff. I also miss the school's sporting activities and all the things that go with it, like practices and bus rides to different schools, having fun, and most of all, I miss being part of a team. So to my fellow classmates who made it through junior high, congratulations again. Be proud of yourselves. Remember, this is the only beginning. We have 4 more years to go, or even more, if you plan on furthering your education. So never give up, and you can do anything you set your mind to. Be kind to one another, respect your parents and elders. If we continue to do what we've been doing, school-wise, and making good choices in life, there is nothing that you can accomplish. I'll leave you with a quote by Zig Ziglar. If you are not willing to learn, no one can help you. If you are determined to learn, no one can stop you. Skoli.
Again, thank you. This is the award that's going to Salutatorian Award 2020-21 for the Hopi Jr. Hopi Junior High School. Brianna Lamaintiwa, we are so proud of you, Hopi Junior High School staff.
Thank you, Brianna, Mr. Vice Chairman. As I listen to the Vice Chairman, you know, the thing that caught me was the cultural and how it put a stop to everything. So I always tease my sisters and everybody, but where are you going? I'm already going to the dance. I'm going up there already. So this weekend and the past few weekends, I was already at the MISO, first one and going up there. So it was a good feeling, though. Seeing the Kachinas come back, so I had that's what really hit me when Mr. Tanakumba was speaking. So I feel blessed that they are back and we're moving on with our lives. And Brianna, day and night, you know, I was little. I don't know her, but when we had our practice, she was shy, but she did very, very good. You know, better than me. Okay, next we have our Hopi Tribal Chairman. He will be presenting the Co-Valedictorian Award. And I present to you Mr. Tim Dubangyoma.
Thank you, Mr. Namoki, for the kind introduction. I want to start by first thanking Mr. Naha. He said it was okay for us to take off our mask, and my ears thank you too, because no matter how much I try to adjust these masks, my ears always end up like this, and I feel like a bat under these lights right now instead of flying around. So, you know, thank you for allowing us to do that. And Mr. Moki, I think you're doing a great job so far. And in the spirit of, you know, the weight that we all gained, I'm glad my tie covers my buns, because my buns are sitting there going, you know, trying to stay closed. You know, so I think I've put on some, well, I know I put on some pounds too. So it's been a crazy year, right? 2020, moving into 2021. But you know what? You guys are all sitting here today because you guys accomplished something. And I think that's going to go down as one of your memories that you all will be able to share in different areas. I also do want to thank the high school administration, the esteemed members of the board, proud parents, proud loved ones that are here honoring the graduates here from eighth grade today, extended family, some of those that weren't able to come that definitely want to be a part of this. But even though we're in limited capacity, we're here. We're here tonight in a better place. But I do want to also acknowledge your former alumni, some of those that were able to move on from eighth grade last year also, who didn't have this opportunity to be acknowledged under these lights for their achievements. So, you know, I don't want to forget about them also. But as you sit here tonight and start looking over the past year, Mr. Lumantiwa, you know, touched on that also, the challenges that you guys probably had, we know that, broadband, connectivity, trying to work with your administrators and your teachers to try to receive the assignments that you all need to get done and turn in. Man, I can't even understand what you all may have faced when it came to that. But as I stand here and having this honor to be invited here to speak with you all, I look at each one of you, and man, I'm proud of you guys. I really am, because I just can't imagine the struggles that you guys have had to deal with to be able to be here in front of everybody today. So, kwakwa, you know, for your efforts in overcoming some of those challenges. The vice chairman, you know, summed up pretty much everything on a lot that we had to deal with over the past year. So I just do want to get to this. And this is really a big honor for me. We don't have one, but two that have received the achievements. So, you know, co-valedictorians, I think that's pretty amazing. So, you know, first one I'd like to recognize Ms. Jordan Lamakima. Jordan, where are you? Ms. Lamakima, hey, there you are. Why don't you come on up? Jordan Lamakima comes from the village of Lower Mungkapi. She is from the Tobacco Bifwangwa. It says Bifwangwa here, but I'm from Musanglabi, so I say Bifwangwa. So she's from the Bifwangwa clan. Her parents are James and Laverne Lamakima. Jordan attended Second Mesa Day School for her elementary school years as a junior high student. Brianna participated in numerous extracurricular activities such as Student Council and the Alliance of Indigenous Math Circles, Art of Inquiry, and the AIS Prep. She showed her Hopi Bruin pride by participating in the sports of basketball and softball. During her time with the junior high, Jordan was an honor roll student every quarter as a principal's list recipient and numerous teacher awards. She also received recognition for perfect attendance. Jordan's future goals are to continue to get on the principal's honor roll list and to make the top three of her high school graduating class. Jordan hopes to obtain scholarships to attend college at either Arizona State University or Stanford University. She aspires to go into the medical field and to become fluent in speaking Hopi. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Hopi Junior High School's co-valedictorian for 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, Jordan Lamakima.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jordan Lamakima. I'm Tobacco Clan and come from the village of Lower Mungkapi. Before I congratulate all of my classmates tonight, I want to thank the people who have helped support me along this journey. Thank you to all of my teachers for giving me words of encouragement and for helping me build up the self-confidence I have now. I'm not just saying this to say it. All of my teachers have had a big impact on my life, whether it was big or small. They made me who I am today, and without them, I wouldn't be the person I am. Thank you to all of my brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles, grandparents, and especially my parents, James and Laverne Lamakima. Without their support and unconditional love, I probably wouldn't be standing here giving a speech to you all. Despite all of my love and affection for them, there are three ladies who are the main reason why I try my absolute best when it comes to my education. Roseanne Pavinyama, Eva Lamakima, and Lorraine Goldtooth. They've shown me true love and I'm very thankful to have them in my life. Although my Lorenzo isn't here with us today, I know she's looking down, smiling at me with happiness. She is to tell me when I get older to earn a lot of money so I can help take care of her. Becoming a doctor was the first thing my mind went to. Even though I don't know what kind of doctor I want to be just yet, I have my heart set on it. This year has been a roller coaster of emotions. Never would I have thought that we would be living in a pandemic. I'm sure we were all very scared going into this pandemic. When I first heard the word pandemic, my mind went to a world where zombies and the walking dead were around every corner of the neighborhood. Not knowing how things would play out for months was very frightening. Not knowing the next time we would be able to see our families and relatives was also very scary. Waking up every morning to prepare ourselves to find out someone we knew our whole lives was gone, was the scariest part of this pandemic. We went through these hard times, not only as a community, but as a family. I'm sure we have all lost someone during this time who we knew. We've all felt the heartache this pandemic has brought along with it. And to those who have felt it more than others, I cannot express how proud I am of you for pushing forward. It takes a lot of courage and strength to do that. Given the circumstances of this year, you should all be very proud of yourselves as well. You did it. Even with the heartache and frustration we have all gone through this year, we were all able to manage to keep up with our education. If that's not impressive, then I don't know what it is. Promoting eighth grade, as it is very hard. Doing it all online is even harder. Who knew that Canvas and Zoom would be used in our everyday life for this past year? Our education is our key to success. This is why we have to keep going. Don't let anything stop you. We are who our elders look up to. We are the next generation. We are our only hope for our elders. Make your life worth it. Don't throw it away. Stay away from drugs. Stay away from vaping, smoking, and stay away from alcohol. In the future, which will be here in no time, I hope to see all of us here. I don't want a single person missing, and I know all of you don't either. We've stuck together since elementary school, and I hope to do the same throughout our high school years. Even if we don't go to the same high school, I speak with my heart when I say this. You can achieve anything you put your mind to. Anything. I believe everyone here is more than capable than doing so. And with that, congratulations to the promoting class of 2021. We did it. Thank you. Ascoli.
Antai Kwakwa. It's my proud honor to present this award to you, Ms. Lamakima. It reads 2021 Valedictorian Award. For Hopi Jr. High School, Jordan Lamakima, we are so proud of you, Hopi Jr. High staff. There's your award, and there's a little something also for you. For me. Well, congratulations again. Okay, thanks again, Ms. Lamakima, for those inspiring words for all of us to hear and your classmates as well. And so we're going to go ahead and move on to the co-valedictorian, Peyton Ticini. Where are you at, Ms. Ticini? Oh, there you are. Why don't you go ahead and come on up. Peyton Ticini comes from the village of Tewa. She is from the Tobacco Bifunwa clan. Her parents are Thurman and Kim Ticini. And before coming to Hopi Junior High School, Peyton attended the First Mesa Elementary. As a junior high student, she participated in numerous extracurricular activities. Gifted and talented, Student Council, and the ALES Prep. She sported her Hopi Bruin pride by participating in cross country and basketball. During her time with the junior high, Peyton was an honor roll student every quarter as a principal's list recipient and numerous teacher awards. She also received recognition for perfect attendance. She was a part of many honors courses and the first in many years, if ever, to take a high school geometry math course as a junior high student. Wow, amazing. Peyton's future goal is to be a successful Native American student and athlete and graduate from high school. Peyton hopes to attend college at either Harvard University or Brown University, where she will study law. She aspires to become a lawyer and to become fluent in speaking her native language. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please join me in welcoming Hopi Junior High School's co-valedictorian for 2021, Ms. Peyton Ticini.
Hi, my name is Peyton Ticini, and I am co-valedictorian of 8th grade, apparently. Okay, so I'd first like to congratulate all of the students who are here or who aren't here, because I do know that it was a difficult year, especially with like the whole online learning and everything. And as a Native reservation on, you know, like as a Hopi community, we don't get as enough technology nor the enough like support from our government. And it was a lot more harder for us to learn, especially in an environment like this. But as, you know, students who are able to adapt and learn, I am very proud of every single one of us, because I think that as a person who has given up on assignments out of frustration and anger, it's very hard to, you know, get an assignment in within like a certain due date instead of like the next day. And I think that as a person who isn't the type of person that doesn't ask for help or is embarrassed to ask questions, it's very difficult throughout this time, because I struggle a lot with that because of, you know, I'm not a very social person very much. And most of the time, I hated turning on my mic to answer questions or even publicly chatting and chat, because I don't know. I'm just too embarrassed to answer the questions. Where am I at? Okay. Sorry. Okay. I didn't want anybody to see me as, like, I guess, a dumb person, even though I have so much knowledge and intelligence in my interests. And, you know, I thought that if I got a question wrong, someone think, okay, this person's, like, not as smart as I thought. Like, you know, like, not what I thought. Okay. However, I always had my family and friends who told me that if I tried my hardest, then my effort would matter. If I tried my hardest, no matter my grade, no matter if I failed a course, no matter if I failed attendance or, I don't know, the Galileo test, I did my best, and that's all that matters. And I think that being, you know, valedictorian is kind of, you know, oh, okay. I thought that it was a great accomplishment for me, because I don't know, as a Native American, because, you know, you don't, as a Native American student, as a a person of color, you don't see that recognition out there. You see, like, a whole bunch of white people, you know, you see non-colored people, you know, get that type of attention, and then they act all surprised, like, when they see, like, a Native American student, they're like, oh, okay, you know? And I think that today is a day to, you know, be yourself and to be proud of who you are. And also that middle school is barely the first step in life, okay? You don't have to worry about it, okay? I feel like you will learn and grow as a person as you, you know, achieve and go on with life. And remember that you deserve it, okay? Okay? And that you are loved, you deserve to be loved, and you are all valid and worthy. Congratulations, eighth grade. Make sure to wear your masks and wash your hands. COVID's still loose out there, so yeah. Thank you. Okay, bye.
That was a great speech, and we appreciate the helpful reminder at the end. We definitely have to keep that in mind. So I'm honored again to present this award, and the award reads 2020 to 2021 Valedictorian Award for Hopi Junior High School, Peyton Ticini. We are so proud of you, Hopi Junior High staff. There you are, Ms. Ticini. I tried so hard not to get the names wrong, but I said that wrong. So. Ladies and gentlemen, our co-valedictorians, let's hear it for them.
Peyton got that smartness from her uncle right here, so I take credit 100%. I taught her well when she became part of our family. She is the goddaughter to our son. So, again, I hope that you use this wisely. Learn how to make beaky like my in-laws. Fill it up. You'll be okay. And if you need how to speak Hopi, you know where to come. Wish you well. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman. And let's give another applause to Jordan and Peyton. Good job, ladies. Peyton, maybe we can switch spots. Social butterfly in the making. And Jordan's tacos are Indian tacos. That big, and Jordan, you're just as smart as your uncles. Combined, Gato, Myron, those guys. So good job. Good job, salutatorian and valedictorian. At this time, I would like to recognize the whole promoting class. You guys made it here. Next year, you're going to have fun. Like I said, challenges coming up. A big thing, you know, I tease my... Well, I got teased a lot by my colleagues, especially Baker and Juwan. So I'm going to flip the switch on this now. Now that his daughter's going to high school, you know, I get to tease him. Where's your shotgun? Where's the potential suitors? And, you know, that's something I look forward to. And, you know, that's something we all, we're special, you know. When you guys get to that age, when you see that cute boy or girl, you know, our first thing on our mind is, please, 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 let him not, or her not be our cousin. not our clan. That's the first thing. So we're special. So those are the things that you get to look forward to. You know, you guys aren't worried about grades. You're worrying about, you know, finding that first love. So, you know, something I get to tease Juwan when he comes to work, and I say, you know what, I guess who I saw, looking forward to that, you know, and I was going to do this as a joke earlier, but I'll try and fit it in, You know, I asked Duan one time, I said, what are you going to call the boyfriend? You call him by his real name? He says, you know what? Did you know there's a vegetarian, has a really, it's an Indian name, and it has a meaning? I said, what do you mean? I said, is that what you're going to call him? Yeah, I'm going to call him a vegetarian. I said, yeah. I said, why? He says, it really means not good at hunting. So, you know, I'm looking forward to those days with teaching me and Baker teasing Juwan. But at this time, please, eighth graders, please rise.
All right, kiddos, are you ready to walk across the stage? All right, it's your moment of glory here. Please come up. If you want to do a elbow tap to our guests here, we also have, if you didn't check under your seat, there's a Bruin paw. You can slip it on, and you can give a big old paw high five to our guests as well. So just a little gift to you all. So however you would like to do it, and we'll go ahead and have Mr. Namoki do our roll call for us.
Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, I'd like to present the class of 2021 promotees. Angelina Antone. Morgan Benali.
Good job, Morgan. Good job, good job. Junior, good job.
Thank
okay.
you, Juwan.
You want to answer?
Yeah.
Okay.
Parents, if you want to take a photo with your son or daughter over there, we have a photo booth, and please do not bum rush the area. And Austin Kolatita.
Good job, Austin.
Austin received an award from my class, Mr. Sleepyhead Award. My first hour, he was always not fully awake when he come on the Zoom. Tryan the Man Dan. He also received an award for me. Tryan. Mr. Zoom Noise Award. When you log in, you can hear in the background his hip hop music or some kind of Bruce Lee movie going on in the back background. Caitlin Onyestewa. Keenan Honyakdewa. Hopefully he'll be a wrestler like his brothers in high school. Thank you.
Keith, on yam tua. Jade Huma. Our salutatorian, Brianna Lamayantewa. Our co-valedictorian, Jordan Lomakima. Don't forget you can teach Gato's class and Bimbo's class. Jeffrey Minigoats. Remember his name. He's going to be one of the top students in high school. Jeffrey. All of them are. All of them are. Nanaba Navayagva. Job, Nanaba. Remember, I won't tell on you. Even the chairman passed a law, he said, vice chairman said, get all the points you want. So it's a go, Juwan. The one Monty Puliella. Never tardy in Zoom, should be the first one to log in. Makwis Suyam to a. He also received one of my awards in class, my mannerism award, every Zoom session. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. How you guys doing? Always checked on everyone. Little jam, we'll wait, everybody get a chance. I don't know if you're aware, but during the day when we have football practice on the field, could be 100 degrees, but when you're on the field, it's actually about 115, 120, so I'm glad we have this in the evening. It's a lot cooler. Edith Silas. Our co-valedictorian, Peyton Ticini. Danelle Ticini.
Dominique Ubella. Jaden Yoyoki. FYI, parents, we will, the photos are going to be loaded to a jump drive, then we will send it to you. So thank you for following our protocols on that. And once again, we'll put it on the jump drive and send it to you. For those of you interested, tomorrow the high school will be having their celebration at 4 o'clock, and it will also be on YouTube. So I'm looking forward to that. Joshua, everything good, Joshua? I want to ask a favor, Joshua. Please disable the comments. I'm not good on criticism. I'll probably hear it anyway from my colleagues, like I mentioned, Baker and Juwan. They'll probably rub it in like they always do. But Juwan's gonna hear it from me this year. I know it. And Baker, I think he's gonna be the MC tomorrow, so the legend will be on YouTube. Get my cliff notes out and take notes from him. We during lunch hours and during breaks sometimes, so I have cross country, and I'll talk to them. And you know, when I did this, I was trying to reflect on what kind of joke should I do? And the jokes that he has and Juwan's has were, I thought about it, they weren't appropriate, so. Yeah, but maybe he'll tell them tomorrow, a little bit older audience, so. You guys ready for high school? No. Remember. member check his or her clan first. Get involved, guys. Get involved. We got art, welding, wood shop. We got extracurricular activities, and that's just not only athletics, guys. We got chess club, art club. Find a niche. Somewhere inside, you have a talent. Find it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2021 promotees. Give a round of applause. All right. Next, Mr. Albanaha.
Thank you, Mr. Namoki. What do you think, guys? Maybe a C for Mr. Namoki tonight, or shall we give him a B? What do you guys think? A? Does he get an A tonight? Yeah! You passed, Mr. Namoki. Good job. All right. Students can be seated. Thank you. We just want to see you all look so good up there, and thank you for standing. Ah, what a perfect night, right? We haven't had this cool in a while. We had a beautiful sunset under the lights, and I have a very happy heart right now. And I get to wrap things up here tonight with the declaration of your promotion. I'd just like to say a couple of words. So good evening once again, promoting students, chairman, vice chairman, Hopi Jr. Senior High School Governing Board, administration, faculty, family and friends. Thank you for joining us tonight in this joyous celebration for our eighth grade promoting class. So today, it was a busy weekend, and as you can see, I'm Leatherface. So I saw some of you out there as well, out in Kikotsmovi, and I am completely burnt up, and my shoulders are hurting, and they're, even though I put sunscreen on and everything, I got burnt. But boy, did it feel good. It felt really good to hurt like that and to be sore and all of that. And, you know, that's part of kind of like I was debating, what am I going to tell you guys? Because normally I think about, you know, I've talked to you guys a lot this year. For, you know, we have our assemblies at the end of each quarter, and I always have some sort of, you know, little thing to share with you all. And I think I've shared about as much as I can. And so I didn't want to get all cliche of talking about the ups and the downs, and those were eloquently spoken by your salutatorian, valedictorian, and our vice chairman and chairman. And, you know, just thinking all about today, and, you know, we came here in the morning, and your staff were out here cooking in the sun, and putting the stage together and decorating it, and us running around, and you probably still saw us running around tonight, and that's just how it goes. We do a promotion or a graduation anytime. You think of everything, and there's something you always forget. So that's okay, students. Remember what I just told you guys this year. No one's perfect, right? We're going to make mistakes. Sometimes we're going to fall down, you know, and that happens. So I didn't want to get all cliche on you and talk about the ups and downs. You know, today all I could be think about all day long, and our vice chairman talked about that, and was home. You're home again, not just your villages. This is your home, too. You've gone 2 years here, and hopefully you'll stay with us, and you have 4 more years. And so over these last several weeks, we as a community have started to emerge back. You know, we've had our dances in our respective villages. And that's all I could think about today was home, because like vice chair, I hadn't seen family for over a year. To see my cousins, my aunts, that felt really good. And that put a smile on my face, made my heart feel good. And I could go a whole 2 more months of school, right? Maybe you're not ready, but I could do another two more months because that's what invigorates me. And to see you here last week for practice and here tonight, it gives all of us, your parents, your teachers, your individuals in the community, with great pride and joy. And we're all smiling today. And that is a great thing. Remember, I told you one time, you don't know just how powerful you are. You give us life. You give us joy. You give us everything. And that is why we do everything for you. And one day you will do that in return. When you have your own kids. Or when you take care of us when we're old and I'm barely going around. Maybe you'll see me walking down the road and you can give me a ride to the store so I can get my slushie. Because I like slushies and pickles. And that's what it's all about, right? Home. You're going to be getting a yearbook. Thanks to, on behalf to our governing board. Free of charge. You don't even have to buy this yearbook this year. So thank you, governing board, for providing this to our students. And it's a very unique yearbook. It's got all your Zoom pictures in it. So it's got all your sleepy head. I think Norman was in his pajamas. Edith was still eating her eggs. But Muckwissa was always ready to go. All the time. Mr. Positive. As everyone, this guy wants so many citizenship. And, you know, just one of those all-around good guys. I think I named his name, like, or his teachers named his name so many times at our awards assembly last week. And I told him about that. I said, to me, those are some of the best awards. Academic awards are great, and I'm proud of all of you. But it's who you are, the character you build, how you live your life. Look in the mirror, and you're proud of who you are because you treated your parents good, you did your chores, you lived the way you're taught. You have a lot to be proud of. You won already. You're successful in life already. So as I was flipping through this yearbook, because I just got it today too, so it's hot off the press here. And I turned, and I got all excited because as you know, some of you know, especially you Second Mesa students, my wife, Mrs. Naha, is Filipino, and so she's Asian. And I saw this Asian page right here. It's ugly, noodles. And as they say, rice is life. Maybe for us it's picky, but for them it's rice is life. And I looked at this picture next to it, and it was drawn by a high school student. And this student's name, she's a high schooler, she was a former junior high, Hangyol Park. She's from the country of Korea. And, you know, we have visitors come out here, we have teachers who are not from out here. And she drew this for us, for you, for your yearbook. And it says, Hopi through the eyes of Hangyol Park, sophomore. You see, guys, this is her home too. And you made that for her. You made that for my sons when they were growing up out here. They were former graduates from here. And this is what we're all about. This is what we taught, and you've been taught, and continue to be taught. That we accept everyone. We respect everything. All living and non-living. Everything is here for a purpose. And home doesn't just mean your home and your dirty bedroom. You guys better clean your room. Dig under that bed. Something probably scary under there. Probably already growing. But your home is not just the home you go to. Home is your friend's house. Home is your village. Home is your auntie's house. Home is wherever you make it. And home is here at Hopi Jr. Senior High School. You are a family to us. And I've told you that a lot of times. We care and we love you very much. And you have all met another milestone. And out there in YouTube land, there's maybe someone watching in another country. Maybe someone's just stumbling across this and they saw this and they're watching it right now. So you better tidy up and look good. Okay? Your future wife or husband might be out there. You never know. But this is your home. This is the only school called Hopi Jr. Senior High School, made for you, fought for you by some of your own grandparents, aunts, uncles, community members. And this will always be a home for you. And you know that. You should not ever hesitate, even if you move away. And sometimes life happens and you move away. But you are always welcome here. And maybe you just joined us this year. Maybe you've been with us for 2 years. But you have met another milestone. And I think Peyton said it best. This don't mean anything yet. It's great. It's great. You did it. Let's celebrate, right? But you got a long way to go. And I try not to really say like this is the end, because it's not the end. You got 4 more years. Maybe some of you might have 5. That's okay. Maybe some of you will struggle. Maybe some of you will thrive. But you're going to do it. And I hope you listen to those words today, because it really warmed my heart. I hope it you really took the message to heart, especially from your classmates. You all stick together. You all support one another. Even when we're angry with one another, right? Even when there's drama. So don't watch that Korean drama. It's bad stuff. I can watch that all the time with my wife. And they're all crying in there and all the time, all screaming and everything, but you know, drama happens. But that doesn't mean you burn bridges, right? That's not what family does. We don't burn the bridge and say that's it. We all need to stick together. That's what we did over this last year and some months. This community came together. Last week, I announced to you all, this was the first time in over a year that this community had a 0% positivity rate over the last 14 days. We did this together. You guys did a survey. Some of your parents did a survey. Over 90% of you are now vaccinated. We did this together. And we did it together to allow what's going to happen for some of your classmates who are not here tonight. And that's why we don't give up on anyone. They're going to come to summer school. And they're going to pass. And they're going to be sitting in those seats at the end of July. And by then, I think we'll be able to have a whole big audience. And I want you all to come back and cheer them on, okay? Because they're going to do it. Because that's what we do together and we support one another. And then we're going to have a big celebration all together. All right? We're all going to go out. We're going to have a good old time. Because we miss that. And we miss you. And I told you at the assembly last week, and I'm going to read it to you again, because it's a good, important message. Although no one can go back and make a brand new start, anyone can start from now and make a brand new ending. So even if something happens, you can always start now. And the world is yours. It's all up to you. But you got a lot of people holding you up, supporting you. You got Mr. Namoki's strong muscles. You got Mr. Novaigua's big brain. Remember I showed a picture of his brain? That's how big it is. You could stand on it. And you got a big heart from all of us. So don't forget about us, all right? Don't forget to say hello. Stop by. You know, you all knew that when you used to come into our office and just chat. Don't forget to do that. Okay, don't forget us at the junior high. You know, we're always looking forward to your next achievements in life. So please, all of you, take care of your kind and smart and creative selves. And thank you what you brought and given to the junior high these last 2 years. And you represented us with great pride and honor, especially. This class is going to be talked about for a long time and what you did. Your living history, in a way. You're going to be in encyclopedias. You're going to be in the annals of all of these things that you did. And as our elementary brothers and sisters and our high school brothers and sisters, and you all are living history. And we did it, Bruins. We did it, kids. Good for you. Thank you. Thank you for not giving up. Thank you, parents, for always supporting. Thank you, teachers. I know that wasn't easy. But you did it as well. And you have a lot to be proud of, teachers. So now, let's do this, junior high. Let's make you a high schooler. It is my pleasure to be here and establish that this 14th day of June 2021 promotion exercise is represented by a certificate which states that the students seated before you today have completed a course of study in accordance with the requirements of the Arizona Board of Education and the Governing Board of Education of Hopi Junior Senior High School, and is therefore awarded a promotion certificate. Promotees, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, by the authority vested in me by the Governing Board of Education of Hopi Junior Senior High School, I proudly present to you the promoting 8th grade class of 2021. Congratulations. Turn around, kids. Parents, stand up. Give them a round of applause. They accomplished so much. We're so proud of them. We love them. All right. Now we get to go home and have a late dinner, huh? All right. Make sure you guys bring me some cake. Our building's open now, so drop a cake by. I'm always looking for something to eat, so me and Trinette. All right. Good job, kids. Let's get you out of here so you can go home. Here's how it's going to work, parents. So if you parked up there, you're going to come down. They're going to ask who you are, who you're picking up. Your kids are going to pick up their real certificate. We didn't want them to lose it or anything. So they're going to pick up a bag of goodies as their certificate. As you come down, they're going to call and we'll bring your child out waiting over there, and they'll be waiting for you. If you park down here, you can meet us over there and we'll check them out as well. All right? So again, let's just follow the proper social distancing and everything. But kiddos, let's march you out. So parents, if you can stick around, we're going to do a formal march out. And I'm going to have Mr. Namoki come back, Mr. A student here, and close up our evening. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Naha. Okay, guys, you guys did it. Good luck next year, and we all believe in you and know you will succeed. At this time, you guys are all freshmen. Right. Have a good evening, a safe trip home. Thank you for coming. Come visit us at our respective classrooms so we can get to know you a little better. Let us know how your high school freshman year is going. Have a good evening and enjoy your evening and have a safe ride home. Thank you.